He got zero suit, but like then you look at Shulk and it's just like, hey, like remember I'm the blonde swordsman, you know, like I still exist in this game. Xenoblade versus Final Fantasy VII, Lilac Cruz, first stage. It's actually a pretty okay stage for both of these characters, so I'm actually not shocked that it ended up going here.
That's right. I remember you were talking about Shulk here last night. I think it was actually the match or the stage that Nico won on versus Smile. So yeah. It was really interesting to see some of the really odd stuff, is how I'm going to put it here, that Shulk can do.
Yeah.
In a good way, though.
Interesting. Both characters just trying to play it optimally safe right now. Already, you see him switch over to Smash Art because he had him off stage and could capitalize with a potential edge guard. Though he was only at 28%, he just wanted the high knockback, not for damage.
That's right. And I really love like this gameplay up underneath the platform that Nico's bringing to the table. We see like that fast fall up air, switch right into the Smash Art, and then we're going to toss out that up tilt. Again, once more.
I mean, Smash Bros. Art's a good art to go into when you have 4% on yourself. The deficit's not going to be too bad. In fact, it might actually help you because some combos won't be able to connect afterwards
there
from
you go.
Cloud.
That's right. That's right.
So Komo's going to have to adapt. I know he plays against Komei in Japan a lot, so he definitely knows the matchup.
Mm-hmm. But let's see if he knows the Nico matchup. Here we are. Yep. We're in the jump.
Oh,
is he going
to try to get the up air afterwards?
Yes, yeah. Right.
The purge.
Now, aren't you supposed to switch into a different art when you go for that,
it
right?
It depends on your opponent's percent.
Percent, okay.
Yeah. Okay, he's gonna have to use his limit to get back to the stage. He's just gonna respect it. Nico doesn't want to get caught by the climb hazard off stage. He's opening up with a double cross slash.
Can we get three? Okay, not three that time. Nico, I like that. Playing safe, just kind of retreating. Komo starting to kick things into high gear. See, and he doesn't mind the fact that Nico's all on him. We're seeing a lot of like back air cross ups. And then, of course, he's using Nair as well, but he doesn't mind it.
That was good patience from Komo. You recognize that Shulk was chasing after him, trying to space it away off stage.
That's right.
Because he was out of resources. He had no double jumps, so he had to just fake it out the forward air. Bait it out. Because if you're quick enough, you could try to react to forward air. It doesn't come out. It's not like the quickest move to come out.
Right.
Now we got Shield Monado Art coming out to try to help him live a little bit. Because that is a Cloud with maximum rage. Back air is going to force him to use his limit break. Never mind.
Okay, goes back into Smash. I like that.
We're in the gambling art.
We are in Vegas, so you know.
Down throw. Not enough to get the kill, even though he's held the red sparks. He manages to get one more grab. Doesn't even need it. Gets the forward air. Nico taking away a first stock from Komo.
Can you really blame Komo, though? I mean, every part of him wanted to not have to burn that limit, because the minute he burned it, you knew that Nico was going to go off stage and try to get him again.
Okay, that was a miss input. A flub coming from Komo Kiri. Probably wanted to turn that around.
Most definitely.
We got the punish coming in from Nico.
Okay,
trying to push him off stage. This is really bad. Smash Mountain Art to try to capitalize on him off stage with no limit.
Komo's really struggling right now. But you know what, though? Even though he's struggling, he's in the deficit here, he understands that his kill options, you know, they're much more open than Nico's. And so at the end of the day, even though he finds himself at a high percent, chances are before Nico will be able to KO him, he'll be able to put some big damage back onto the board here. And as we see right now, Nico's sitting at 99%. In the jump, Monado, but switches back over to speed. I like that. Oh, wow.
Neutral air into forward air.
And this is why I love the speed art. Just being able to just apply so much pressure and just really not stopping the assault.
Komo just pushing him back off stage. He's sitting at 132% with Shield Mount Art to try to help him live a little bit. Komo's not going to be able to get the kill. I mean, at this point, he could land a cross slash that could go for the kill.
Mm-hmm. Up air once more.
Yeah, just don't let him land. I mean, when you're Shield Mount Art, it lowers like your maneuverability. You're not able to like go across the stage as fast.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's worn off. He's going to have to play super safe. He's looking for a grab. Finally just plays it super safe with the back air, still living at 166%. Often just switches the jump to try to get some recovery. Stalling probably waits for Shield Mount Art to come out, but that overhead press from Cloud's going to be able to send him to the top into the space.
That's right. 52%, definitely a good position to be in here for Komo, if I may say so myself. Not bad. Has limit online here. Mm-hmm. He's been playing pretty good, even though he's found himself in the passenger seat. But as we've seen in the past, you know, Komo doesn't need much room. He doesn't need much wiggle space to turn a bad situation back into a good one.
Now, Nico's going to try to capitalize on getting rid of the limit break. That's his main goal right now.
That's right. Okay, another up tilt. We're trying to sneak that in there. Komo certainly on the up and up. There's the 1-2-3 jab. And we typically don't see Shulks go for a lot of jabs up close unless they're switched over into that shield art. Okay.
Now, again, the reason he was going for the smash because he just wanted to push him off stage, not go for a kill necessarily, but just try to force out the limit. And Komo's holding onto it as long as possible because he recognizes that he's at a huge disadvantage off stage without it.
Did you see how quick that Nair came out for Komo? He was like, look, if your forward air hits me, I'm actually deceased. Monado purge, not that time.
He's going back into the shield again. Just give him some breathing room. Doesn't get too much damage off of it. Nice evasion with these jumps. Both carry players are playing super patient. This is Komo's opportunity. Has him off stage with the back here. Try to go for the forward air, but Nico just goes back onto the stage with the air dodge.
I like that. Rapidly approaching the minute mark here, too. Both of these two players certainly in this for the long run. Goes low, gets the limit, but here is the smash R once more.
He's out of limit. Nico could potentially go for an air dodge. Goes for the forward air, gets the kill on the platform. Nico taking away game number one from a top 10 player, Komo Rikiri.
You know what's crazy? You know, so Nico obviously has gone through different strides in Smash in his career. You know, there's sometimes where he's feeling really good. There's sometimes where he feels like he needs to retire. But what's going to happen here to his mindset if he beats Komo Akiri? I expect to see him go ham throughout the rest of Smash 4 into Ultimate if he can win this.
I mean, you know, he's definitely waiting to see what could happen in Ultimate for this character. But
yes, sir.
Here we go. Aren't we all, man? Smashville, Komo Akiri opting to just go for that platform to help him build a little bit of limit, because that's like the key in this matchup, is you just don't want to be offstage against Shulk.
Mm-hmm.
As long as you're not offstage against Shulk, you are winning the matchup.
Wow. All right. I just learned something new. All right, man. But nonetheless, though, we don't really get to see too many instances in this match where Nico's playing without any of his arts online. But it looks like in the beginning of this match, he was trying to find a bit of an opening here for the grabbing, which is pretty odd, if I may say so myself. You know, a lot of Shulks kick off the match with, like, that speed art, looking to go for a lot of pivot grabs or try to cross the opponent up. But maybe there's something he knows about Komo Akiri that we don't.
Ooh, catching his offstage run with the up airs. Catches the double jump as well. He's in his head. He knows exactly where he wants to go. And is just getting punish after punish.
Back throw.
The adaptation could be real for Komo Akiri.
Okay.
Trying to space out the back air is very safe. Nico opting to go for the shield out of art while he's at a high percent.
Let's get it. Okay. Oh, wow. That was smart. But yep. He's actually living, though.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Barely living that with the shield out of art. But he caught the roll onto the stage with the climb hazard, spending his limit. Now he's caught in a bad spot, which is why he's going for the jump in outer wart, trying to capitalize off stage. But now he's getting caught by the up air. He wants to switch back to shield.
Okay, smart man, 157%. But while that's online, he'll certainly be in a good spot here. Komo not stopping the aggression once more. Can't quite find the grab off the ledge. I think he had the roll read scouted out.
That was almost the scariest moment
ever. Right.
He connected that forward air off stage. But thankfully, Komo was holding on to his double jump, managing his resources correctly. And now, again, another missed input coming from Komo.
You know,
the second time we've seen the blade beam go in the wrong direction.
That could be a missed input, but he could have also just tossed it out on purpose. You know, there's a point in time in a match where your opponent's showing you too much respect. And because he's doing that, you might not be able to find any openings yourself. I've seen Max kind of waste a KO punch just because the opponent just won't approach. So that could have been a situation like that there. Nonetheless, though, the limit never stops coming. Back online here, both of these two characters glowing some very odd colors here.
Yeah, I got blue versus yellow. As we try switch over to the green one, we got jumping out of water, giving him some more jumping distance. But he also takes the most damage in this form, and he's got to capitalize on trying not to get hit.
That's right.
Because he's already down by a stock. He's just got overlapped. See how much damage that back air did to him when he was in jump?
Yeah, it did quite a bit. Okay, back into the shield that time. Gets the fourth throw. Okay, can't quite get there in time to go for the fall, but that's okay, though. Gets the... Oh!
Yeah, cross
slash. I knew he was going
to
do that.
Cross slash limits is a very safe move. It's hard to punch, especially with Shulk. He doesn't have too quick of moves. Like, forward tilt was one of his quickest burst options he could have gone for, and it wasn't enough.
Right.
It's besides, like, jab, but he wouldn't have gotten much off of jab. There you go, shield.
Okay. It's the 1-2-3 jab once more. Yeah, Komo really holding down the ledge of the stage. I'm really liking this this ledge pressure that he's really applying here to Nico. Okay, there's a back. Oh, my
nice
goodness.
Catch
gracious.
From Komo. Just jumps off the platform, connects the downer, spikes him into the blast zone with a solid two-stock victory for him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is another example where just because you won game one doesn't necessarily mean you got the set. Komo Akiri is adapting to both the character and the player.
There it is. Now, Nico, we've talked about that, you know, he is known for his Shulk, but, you know, we talked a bit about his Marth. We're not...
Not seeing it.
Okay,
Shulk
actually
only,
going Shulk. Okay.
I mean, like I said, he feels comfortable in this matchup with Shulk. There's really no reason. I feel like he goes for Marth when he's trying to fight against someone, where he feels like it's a losing way too bad of a matchup for Shulk.
That's right. And like you talked about, this isn't that bad of a matchup for Shulk. It just has to be played very, very refined and very – it has to be played with perfection. But there are a few aspects of his play style that I really feel like, you know, would really help him out if he played Marth as well. You know, most specifically the ledge game and then, of course, the offstage game as well. I mean – If Cloud decides to recover high and his head pops up above the ledge, just like how Lucina can do Little Mac, Marth can just down tilt Cloud as well.
Yeah, speaking of down tilts, we haven't seen too many of them from either character. I mean, obviously from Cloud, but you know, down tilt's a pretty good just a spacing tool for Shulk. You just kind of push an opponent away from him.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we got the jump Monado art.
Okay,
trying
both
to play the neutral
guys,
game.
Yes, sir. And both these two guys kind of spacing each other out here. I'm starting to see a lot more nairs. Whether it's the, you know, facing Nair or the reverse hitbox of Nair, nonetheless, Komo, you know, using it to really get under Nico's skin.
Like the falling up air, trying to catch it. Nice, just the falling down neutral air, just sending Komo to the side. Tried to read the normal get up with that cross slash limit. Chasing him off stage, reads the air dodge read. That could be a potential stock. Tried to get that forward air. If he connected that forward air, that would be his entire stock. But he just misspaced it. Good timing from Komo. Mm-hmm. Just trying to mix up when he was going to go for the ledge.
Okay, forward throw.
Another opportunity.
Okay, yeah, that's smart. He went. He recovered high that time because he was expecting Nico to go for a dare off the ledge. Or dare right through the ledge, excuse me. Nonetheless, there's the forwarder. We've seen the red sparks, though. Como still hanging on for dear life.
Nico was just playing on the stage, but Como finally finds a way. He's back on stage, but now we're going to the right side, coast to coast. Almost running out of limit. Again, trying to get that forwarder out to come out just in time. It's a little bit too slow to catch him.
Okay, yeah, okay. He's looking for a pivot grab. Como just has all his options scouted out. And it really hurts Shulk here. I feel like sometimes when you go up against Como, because since you're so up close and personal, you can't quite box quite as well as, oh, it's Como, but
nice
regardless,
stuff.
Doesn't matter what I was saying, though.
That was a good limit break, a blade beam. That was a good gamble from Como because he was just trying to throw it in case it caught Nico, it would kill him, but if not, it buys him enough time to grab onto the ledge. Mm-hmm. But Nico got the guard and immediately just went in with the forward air, got the kill. One stock away from sending top 10 player Como Rikiri into losers. Can Nico pull it off?
Okay.
Smash from Nottawar. Oh, that would have been dangerous.
I love the fact that Como always uses that first hit of cross slash to give himself that alleviation back onto the stage, man. Just you got to get that pressure up off, you know what I mean? Okay, back up into the platform.
It looks like Como's doing a lot of down smashes just in case Nico wants to play a little aggressive and approach him because he's at a super high percent. But Nico is trying to use that long Monado to just stay at a distance. But Speed Nottawar kind of like wants you to get in there and try to cross up with a neutral air. Limit break, ready to go. Oh, trying to get the forward air follow-up. It gets grabbed by Como as a punish game.
Yeah, I think he did a little bit too much, man. Goes for the forward, but it kind of looked like he was going for a grab himself that time. Okay,
ooh.
Both hits of the up special. That was smart.
Yeah, he held down, did not grab onto the ledge. You go for the second swing of air slash. Gets back onto the stage. Pretty easy. Doesn't. Oh, thought he was going to go for a grab afterwards, which is why he let go of shield too soon.
That's right. Back throw once more. Find himself off stage again. Really struggling here to find his KO.
Down air.
Oh,
where
whoa.
Is he going? Hello?
What was that,
that trajectory?
Angle?
He was DIing that right so hard. He went flying for that down air. Okay, still sitting at 39%. Como's still in his game.
Mm-hmm.
Just again, opting cross slash is just good meaty damage, even if it's not in limit form.
Yeah, for sure. Both these two guys trading.
He's the neutral get up.
No.
He's chasing after him. He goes a little bit too low. He gambled too hard
right.
on Como going recovering low instead of high. If he would have recovered low, that would be the entire set.
Mm. Okay. Limit is certainly the biggest factor here. Chopping away here at this lead. Oh, my goodness. That was a back air. I felt like that was supposed to be down here. But nonetheless, though, Nico lives to fight another day. But for how much longer? Como looking like he's starting to figure some stuff out. Okay, delayed jab. That was smart.
Yeah, Como playing super safe with these retreating neutral airs.
Uh-uh.
Just a good, like, tool just to, like, keep Shulk away from him. Has him offstage. He's going to build some limit instead.
Uh-uh.
Trying to get him with the neutral air, but his neutral air is faster. You got to respect it.
Okay, he's back into shield once more. On the ledge, a roll that time. I love that. Como's ability to read how you're going to get up off the ledge is unmatched sometimes.
Nico wants to finish this. He's in Smash from Nottawart. He has him. Como just playing safe. Ledge jumps instead. Goes for the back air himself. He went flying because of the Smash from Nottawart. Has to go for the ledge, avoiding the down air. He has limits. Got to respect it. Como could let that rip at any second. He wants to set when he doesn't want to get sent to losers this early.
Back throw. Okay. There's the forward tilt. Oh, okay, looking for the tomahawk.
Yeah.
That was smart. Again, another forward throw, but what can he turn these offstage opportunities into?
He's running. Tried to go for the grab. Como got it first. Trying to see what he's going to do, just jumping around and playing super patient. Jumping out of art to get to the stage.
His ability to read the ledge game is so good. Como Kiri.
He's
a monster.
He's waiting for Como to just commit to any option here. He's got limit ready to go. Gets the back air to the safe. And the sound, the crowd going nuts. Como Rikiri coming from the depths of losing 2-1 against Nico. We almost saw like the biggest potential upset.
That's right. And you know, that's a different Como Rikiri than I guess what we're used to. You know, we're so used to Como just closing out matches really quick at the drop of a hat. But this time he was in for the long run.
Yeah, I mean, Nico is not a slouch, man.
Yeah.
It was a